Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to a video that I haven't done before. It's actually going to be quite new to me. Pretty much what I'm doing is I'm going to show you some of the highlights from my recent M46 third mark session. Don't expect too many of these because three marking tanks is not easy for me because I'm bad. And yeah, enjoy the games. Alright guys, this is the first replay on mines. South spawn. First things first, it's a tier 10 game. All four of these replays that I'm going to be showing you are all tier 10 games. So just kind of showing you that you don't, you really shouldn't be discouraged by tier 10 games, as you have equal chance of contributing if you just play well. Right now I'm just waiting for my opportunity to get up on the hill or maybe sit, take some shots at the enemies that poke up. So I'm trying to keep an eye on the M41 while my heavy tanks are moving up. T-30 just fired, so I'm starting to inch up a bit more. See if I can get some shots at this RU, but I can't, so I'm just gonna back up. DB pops up, he takes 1900 damage, so that was pretty good for us. I shoot the T-30 in the track just to keep him still. The T-30 hits our T-95 E6, I think it's called. Yep, so I take advantage of that and shoot him. I thought I retracted him there, but I didn't, which isn't a big deal. Heavy Z bounces my side somehow. I really don't know how he did that, but he managed to, so good for him. Actually, it just said he damaged both my left and right track, which I'm really confused about. That's weird. Right now, what I'm trying to do is pretty much just get some shots on anything I can. The team's actually doing really well right now. We haven't lost a single tank yet, and we've already taken out a tier 10, a tier 9, and a tier 8. Veloxa right there, he's from Bulba, so I know he's a very good player. I don't want to outright focus him, and I wasn't actually outright focusing him. I was just keeping him in the back of my mind, knowing that he's a good player, and that he's dangerous. Most of the time I can usually kind of expect puppies to make some kind of questionable decisions or maybe bounce a shot or two if I angle correctly, but with players like that, pretty much anything goes. A tortoise camping base, because that's what tank destroyers are supposed to do, right? And artillery is supposed to prevent that, but, you know, it doesn't. Sniper's hiding from the tortoise and not trying to get shot by him. I throw a shot into his little cupola up on top there. I get lit, probably proxied by the WZ, which is fine. I'm not worried about it. Tortoise fires across here, or like I would peek to see if Velox is going to be there, because I really don't want to get shot by a girl 15. That would really, really suck. Here I peek over, trying to get a shot at the Conway and the pretty much any other tank there. This shot though, I don't know what I was thinking. I shoot at his turret, and for some reason the Conway's turret always troll bounces me when he had a perfectly exposed hull. I just don't understand my logic there. There I try to shoot the lower part of the T-50/41's turret ring, but the T-50/41 makes no sense with its armor layout, so. Whatever. Probably should have just gone for the side anyway. I probably would have penned. C-50/41 actually gives me a lot of trouble with the way that he drives his tank. It's so weird, I just didn't expect it. But. So, I shoot down that building, pull back into cover, still get lit anyway, because that's just how things work. I poke out, I try to shoot him in the little turret cheek again, but it doesn't work. He misses. I try to shoot his upper plate because I figure I'm looking down on it. But again, and then he pens me on the move. Like, I don't know. I was thinking about going down, and then I was like, no, the Type 61's there, and the Conway hasn't been lit yet, so that's like a 3v1, maybe a 2v3, with the E3 on my side, but like, I just don't want to risk that at all. It's just not worth it for me. So right here, I'm trying to get behind the Type 61, to help out my E3 a little bit indirectly. The Conway, he tries to shoot me because he has an obsession with me, and I shoot him back because I actually hit my shot. The tortoise hits me, or maybe that wasn't. I think I see that shot right there always confuses me because I'm pretty sure. Yeah, it was the tortoise. It had to be because the 5041 hit me first. So yeah, that's the tortoise, definitely. Just weird because they made it. Oh no, do you know what that could have been? WZ-120. Because the shot kind of came from like their base-ish. And WZ-120 was pretty much like right on that line. I think that's what happened at least. It was one of them. It was like a 400, 420, 440, something like around there. It was enough that I don't want to get hit by it again, that's for sure. This is where kind of hit logs are kind of useful because you can just see what hit you and it's easy for commentating. Honestly, I don't really need it for gameplay because it's like, if you get hit for 420 or for 440 or 400 or whatever, you know it's one of them, so you know both of them, or I just assume that both of them have a shot, and just play carefully. And it sucks because I'm actually forced to play carefully with this E3, the way he's playing. I don't know why he just didn't go around and take the shot, because the tortoise wasn't going to have a shot. And I rushed that. I shouldn't have rushed that. I wasn't in any real danger of getting shot there. The tortoise is just HE-ing him down, and the Conway was gonna be a one shot for him. But now he's just getting proxy lit and by the Conway, and I can't really help him because the tortoise is in base and not able to get spotted. So I really feel bad for the Z3 because he's. I get why he's not rushing, because, you know, there's three tanks or whatever, but, ugh, it's just, it's trouble. So, I move, and I wasn't expecting to pull the tortoise's attention off the E3, but I did, so that's a plus. I try for that again, it just goes slightly over, because the M46 is not the most accurate tank in the game. 0.46 accuracy is pretty, ugh. So, the tortoise bounces at the top of my turret. This thing's turret's actually kind of weird in the way, like, how it bounces stuff. You don't get many, like, if they hit the front of your turret, you're pretty much gonna get penned every single time. And I'm pretty sure this thing almost has, like, I don't even think it really has a noticeable mantlet, like, oh, it does. I just forgot how it looks. It's a very small mantlet. And I think the tortoise must have bounced my viewport there or something, because that's the only part that was showing. But pretty much the tortoise was crossing there and I had a shot for like a couple milliseconds. It's just he slipped away, which is unfortunate, but it's fine. Right now I'm just getting into a position where I can really dominate the map. There's really almost no chance of us losing this because it's 3v6. The problem is two of our tank destroyers are not doing anything useful. And they're just chilling in the back of the map. It's WZ-120. I guess he must have, like, just not thought I was gonna be here. Because I don't think I got lit at this point. Maybe I did, but, I thought I got lit by the tortoise, but whatever. So he's dead by the girl 15. E-75 is occupied with girl 15, so I start moving towards the tortoise. Both our Jagdpanzer and our E-3 are one-shots. So I'm pinging the map with the tortoise, and what I really, like, if once the tortoise was dead, we were going to win anyway. There was almost no chance we could lose, because it was going to be, it was going to be 5v1 at that point. The Jagdpanzer misses. I take a YOLO snapshot, because why not? I was going to be under his gun anyway, and he wasn't going to be able to hit me, and I wasn't going to be able to hit him until I went up the ramp, so I figured I just took it. And it worked out, which is cool. I noticed that it was RNG. It was definitely an RNG shot on the move, but a shot that small, like, yeah, it was 100% RNG. And, the Girl 15 finishes off the E-75, and that was that. That was an ace tanker. I'll have the post-game stats up here somewhere. It's just I can't remember how much damage or anything that was. So, yeah, on to the next one. Alright guys, here we are on Abbey. We got South Spawn. So, this is the first game that I started platooning with PM Rocks with. And he PM'd me in-game and said, Majora's, can you carry me? And he was clearly joking, but like, he just wanted a platoon mate, and that's fine. I really enjoy platooning with PM. He's a really helpful teammate, unlike most puppies, because he actually does useful things, and if he needs to, he can take a shot, or if I need to, I can take a shot for him, and we just work well together. So that's really cool. So I just go through the Type 61's turret front, because the Type 61 has such garbage armor, it's not even funny. Right now, I'm just trying to pretty much shoot anything that tries to come up the middle. If anything tries to come up the middle, which they're not going to. Probably seeing a TBP and an MX-30 and a M46 here, they probably got scared off. So, PM is going over to the 1-2 line, and he's trying to fight with the heavies and make sure that we don't lose that flank, because that is an incredibly important flank on this map. However, our E5s are so downs. I don't know why they set a G2 the entire game, but they were so useless, and so PM tried to make a push, and I think that's probably where he made his mistake this game, is trying to initiate that push. Like, yeah, he had the support of the TVP and the WZ-120, but I think it was a WZ. Apparently it wasn't. Object 140, that's what it was. So that's great. He had the support of two mediums, but like, he doesn't have the support of two E5s. Those E5s were just... they're those kind of people that just do everything wrong. But, so I let the team know that their heavies are already in position, because I bounced a shot off my side from the M48 as well as the IS-7, which means that the IS-7 is at F2 or F3. Our Jagdpanzer is talking trash in chat, because obviously by not pushing the 8-line you're a retard or whatever. So right now I'm just farming the side of these tanks over here. Me and PM were having such a good time during this third mark session. I think when I had him in my platoon, we were at like 92%, or I was at 92% on the mark or something. Which is actually really, really interesting, because like, I went up 3% with a platoon mate. And he really helped me out with that. So I'm glad that I platooned with him. It's nice to have a platoon mate because it's someone to rely on. Like, you don't have to worry about puppies all the time. Like this bat chat, he doesn't really do me justice later. But if, like, if that was a platoon mate and a bat chat, and I understood the that, like, you can't really do much when you have one hit point, but, you know, if you time things right, they'll work out way, way better. So this T-30 is not paying attention, so I shoot him. I shoot him blind, like, but it does hit, because he literally could not move out of the way that fast. So it was definitely a hit, but, we don't know how much damage it was, yet. Like, the exact number. But I just assume it's 390 every time, because that's what it should be on average. That replay was really weird. It didn't show that I was actually aiming at the T-54, because replays are really, really weird in this. So right now I'm just farming the people. I wait for the IS-7 to move, because the 704 is a one-shot, and I want to get rid of that 750 Alpha gun. And most likely I would have, I wouldn't append the side of an IS-7 like that anyway. So here's the E-50, and the bat chat is 145 HP, and I'm waiting for him to help me, which is fine. I'm like, but I don't know why he goes now. He knows that the E-50 fired me about 8 seconds ago, so the E-50's loaded, but he just goes anyway. Which, it was helpful because he put one more shot into him, but like, come on, dude. Having that bat chat with me the rest of the game would have probably made the difference. But whatever. You know, I've learned to expect so little from public match players just because I don't want to be constantly disappointed, and it really does help me keep the rage under control. I'm just... ugh. This game is definitely the most irritating and most frustrating game to play, because you just expect people to know how to do basic things, and they fail you, and then you're set. So that shot took me a while, because I wanted to make sure that was E5's back and not his front, because obviously an E5's front is not going to get penned, ever. And so I just looked on my map and saw that his turret was facing the other way, and most likely he was going to be moving a way that was beneficial for me. So the mouse accidentally angles for me, which is kind of suck, but it's what it is. Meanwhile, I'm keeping my eye on the map. I see that WZ-120, he was last spotted at, like, D4. So I know he's coming for me. Like, it's just a matter of time. He's gonna be coming for me. There's nowhere really else that he can, go, except for, to come for me. So I'm peeking, and I'm making sure he's not there yet. And I don't know why I drove over here. I guess I was trying to, like, see if I could get a shot on the Buffalo Dim on a 3, and then I realized that no, both of them are covered. So I shoot a gold round at the WZ, because I just have them loaded for... oh no, maybe it wasn't a gold round. But I'm loading them now, because this is an important fight to win. So both of them hit me, both the T-54 and the WZ. That T-54 needed to die no matter what, because that was an ally on the WZ side, and making this a 1v1 instead of a 2v1 is much more winnable. So right now I'm just trying to outplay him the best I can. He shoots my track, I shoot his track. Mine was probably a more likely thing to go through, because of the way that he was kind of angling. He fires at the E-50's body. Both of us pretty much have just fired. I know I can beat his DPM, but I don't know by how much. I just killed him, but like, I didn't know if it was gonna be less than like half a second or something between our shot. But yeah, I'm definitely proud of how I played there, and it really just shows that if you micro your tank well enough, then a lot is winnable. See, I should have been paying attention to the map here, because when the M103 got unlit, he was heading to his right and my left, so I should have known that he was going to be popping over at D7. The mouse is a 3-shot kill, according to my AgPanzer. which is fine. But here's probably where I make my critical mistake. I was trying to get to the 1-2 line, because then I could control the map with my superior camo and my view range and all that. But like I said, the M103 went over D7. Probably took him a little bit. He was probably waiting in that bush, like trying to see if he could spot me or something. And he came over and let me in. So I'm trying to get some last minute damage here, just maybe try to get this top gun. But my gun was just not cooperating, or I was under pressure and panicking. I don't really know what it was. So I shoot the lower plate with gold and it bounces because the M103 is apparently Jesus now, but whatever. So that was the abbey game. Pretty sure that was over 6,000 damage, 5 kills. I don't think it was any assisted, but yeah, that was a good game. I'll have the post-game stats up here on the screen. And yeah, let's get into the next replay. Alrighty guys, here we are in Westfield, and I spawned on the bottom of the hill, so I was complaining to PM about this, so I was like, oh man, every single time. Just joking around, but yeah, basically, want to get up to the top of the hill, exploit my gun depression, use my gun, because gun using is cool, and lucky PM. He gets up on the hill pretty quickly. So I'm just trying to get up there with him because the hill is my favorite part of this map. It has everything you really need. If you have a gun depression tank, you can use that main hill that PM's on. He's not in a gun depression tank, but it actually still works with a T10 for some reason. I use mine there all the time and it works out pretty well. The E100 even surprisingly works well there. If you have a tank with like armor, it usually works well. Or if you just have a lot of depression, like a CDC or something, it still works well. You just have to be quick about making your shots happen. Be very unpredictable. Can't see it because of the outline bug, but I shoot D5 in the cupola, and only the front of the cupola is strong. The sides and rear of it suck. And I go to shoot the Conway, but 0.4 accuracy and some bad luck just makes that not happen. Just experiencing some stuttering on frame rate right now, that's weird. That might have been actually happening during game, I don't know, but... So, again, the replays suck, but I can see his side slightly. So I just shoot through it because E50's side is kind of bad if you angle it too much. And he angled it too much, so I shot him inside. I was gonna poke up and shoot the grill, because usually those TDs that camp in the back are such easy farm with a gun depression tank. They just can't respond to you fast enough if you're not spotted. Unless they get like super lucky and just predict where you're going or you pop up in the same spot for some reason. So I shoot the 100 inside of the turret. The Centurion hits me. That's fine. I would rather take a hit for my team while trying to deal damage to this E100 and 140 than to not take a hit and not do the damage, because that's actually a very good trade for me, because I'm taking damage for... Did they really just do that? I didn't even notice that. I thought I was taking damage that entire time. Cool. Okay. I would rather take damage as a tier 9 than not take damage and have a tier 10 take damage. It's trading. It's like a bat chat. If you rush a bat chat with a tier 8, yeah, you'll die, but it's more beneficial for your team because it's a tier 8 gets getting clipped and not a tier 10. It's pretty small stuff. I mean, like if you're platooning or something, it could help, or if it's a 15v15, that could definitely help, like a like an organized play or something. But here the game's pretty much over, so I'm just trying to go and get last minute damage. I got PM right beside me. But unfortunately, I'm really dumb and shoot his angled side. I auto-aim the STB because he wasn't too far away. And that'll probably work. I try to trade with the STB. That was really dumb of me. He tries to get the kill, I track him and damage him with the same shot. Because I just took my time aiming that one. Try to hit the bat chat. Not gonna happen. I think it's important to note that here that I only fired 3 gold rounds through the entire course of this match. And I think 2 of them, maybe even all 3, bounced. Because the first one was off the turret front of the 100. Which only had less than a 50% chance going through. The second one bounced off the 100's lower plate. And I think the third one might have been to the 140's lower plate. I'm not sure. Then we have Classic Pub complaining about aimbots, which don't help players who know what they're doing anyway. See, now I was thinking about poking and trying to get that shot on his cupola, because his cupola is absolutely massive. But, I have 148 HP, he does 390. It is literally not possible for him to low roll enough that I live. So let's survive instead and get some more damage. So I did that. And I just now realized that that bat chat was actually the E5 that I shot in the butt on the Abbey game. Cool. Alright, so that was the third replay. I'll have the post-game stats up on the screen. I'm gonna have to go back and get the actual damage and like the detailed, or the team score, that's what it's called. Or the team report, whatever, thing from the WOT replays and put that up there as well for both of those. Let's go on to the fourth and final replay. Alright guys, we're on steps and this is the final game for my third mark session. Just so there's no confusion, it wasn't 4 battles and then I was done. It was, I think 20 or 21, I think it was 20. 20 battles going from, I think, about 89 to 90%. Maybe even 91, I can't really remember, all the way up to the 95. And this was the game that I finished it off. So if you're on the EU server and you hate gold, or you're just a gold hater in general, because you believe it takes no skill to fire all gold, then you might want to avert your eyes because it's going to hurt. Even if that round wasn't a gold round, the chance of that not going through was so low that it doesn't even bother me that I was firing gold right there. And it doesn't bother me that I fire gold anyway, because I have the credits to actually fire it, because I do enough damage to actually supplement the income. Imagine that. But anyway, 90% of the stuff that I shoot this game, I wouldn't have needed the gold rounds anyway, because they were so lightly armored. The only reason I really had the gold rounds loaded was for the E5 or the 183, in case they decided to come over here. So I shoot the STA right through the turret. Again, wouldn't have needed a gold round for that. But I figured I'm just going to go ahead and explain why I wouldn't have needed a gold round there. For every single shot that I make this game, just to prove that gold rounds really do not make a huge difference. Gold rounds actually do have a very important role in this game. And that's just to mitigate the RNG factor, because for tanks like the E100, you have 235mm of penetration. And I've done the math so many times before, so I'm pretty sure it's around 176. But it can low roll really, really low. So low, in fact, that you can actually... Yeah, 176.2. You can actually bounce the front of an IS-3 with your E-100 AP shells, 15cm by the way, just because the game decides that you're not going to defend, which makes no sense to me, because if using standard rounds improves your skill, according to most pubbies, then how is letting your rounds be dictated by literal RNG and luck skillful. I don't get it. Like, I've tried talking to so many people who are against gold rounds to figure out why they're against it, and their main thing is it takes no skill because it pens every round. Okay. Heat, for example. That's a gold round. However, if you've ever tried to fire a heat round against tracks, you'll realize that that doesn't really work. Also, you'll see later in this very replay that I shoot a tank with a gold round. Doesn't pen. The reason that people use gold rounds is to... Actually, this is one of them. It has higher shell travel time, so it's easier to lead shots. Because nobody wants to lead your shot 100 feet and then have them decide to turn right and then you miss your shot because of it. It's dumb. But shell travel time, it does take skill to learn it, so that's fine. I'm not concerned with shell travel time being an argument for the no gold guys or whatever. I don't really know how to explain it. I just hate when they say, oh, gold rounds are like cancer. It's no, they have a place. If you're an A100, you need to fire gold rounds in order to be competitive, because if you don't, then you're gonna bounce literally everything just because of luck. Oh, here, by the way, side of an E5, that wasn't a critical hit. I just didn't penetrate his armor. 265 millimeters of penetration with these gold rounds, by the way. And it didn't pen. Okay. I will give it to the gold round users, though. The shot coming up right here. Yeah, that wouldn't have happened without a gold round. But is it just left-click, right-click? No. Or right-click, left-click? No. If you auto-aim everything with a gold round, you're probably going to pen maybe 30% of your shots, depending on what you're shooting at. Because tanks have armor, and armor actually does work. Which is weird, because a lot of people don't believe that. They think armor is completely useless, but it isn't. Alright, so I've ranted about gold rounds and pubbies for quite a while. Alright guys, so here are the post-game stats. You can see in the top right there that it's 3 marks, and it's only a first class, which kind of sucks. It would be nice if it was an ace, but yeah, I got a high caliber, and it was 4.9k damage. Though people tell me to round down, but rounding down is boring. So, 4878 damage, 3 kills. 1,222 XP, along with some other medals. You can see the PM was pretty much right behind me at 3.6k, because he's a good player. And so now I have the spreadsheet right here, and here are the 20 games that I was talking about, and along with the map, the experience total for that match. The first one doesn't have Sacred Valley was the one I won. Or maybe it was Maravanka, I don't know. But the first one that I won, I took off the double XP bonus. Got the credit profit, kills, assisted, damage, and normal damage, as well as the battle number. And then the averages and sums all up down at the bottom. 3.8k damage per game. I think that's pretty good. And I'm very happy with that result, so... If you guys like this video, go ahead and leave a like, do whatever you want. I mean, if you didn't like it, because gold or something stupid like that, leave a dislike. Yeah. So, like I said, don't expect too many of these, because third marks are not easy for me to get, and I'm bad. And I'd have to do them at, like, tier 5, because tier 8 through 10 third marks are a bit tricky for me. And I will see you guys in the next video.